सर।
So what is the definition of the key? So today's topic is we are talking about the candidate key, super key, primer key, foreign key, and composite key. Like this, we have a lot of keys over here. So we'll be seeing about the one by one. So when I'm saying the keys, so it's an attribute. So again, I told you just now. So it's an attribute in that which is going to identify a tuple. It will going to identify a tuple or a row in a table. So in a table we have something, lot of columns are there, rows. So rows is being record. So when the record is being given over there, so in order to pick up that particular row from that particular table, because the row is linked to that particular table, so there is a relation has been established in that particular table in a form of record. So in order to identify a record, we need keys. Okay, so here how I'll be identifying. One, I want to identify the column. Okay, one, I want to identify the column, and also it is going to identify the row in a table by the combination of one or two columns. So here, if I want to maintain any uniqueness, if I want to make any uniqueness of the record or a table of or a row of the table, then we are going to use the database key. So here I have given an example that there is something called employee ID is there, name is there, last name is there. So as I was discussing in the ER diagram and all the things I was telling you about that, there are some attributes. So here employee is the entity and ID, the ID and the name and the last name, whichever that you are finding, these are the attributes of that particular database. So when the particular database is existing, in that first name I cannot trust, because this name cannot be the same, because the people names can be existing more than one and twice. Okay, so maybe last name I can have, but comparing to that there may be something, there is any siblings also with there in the same college or the office or something. That means anyhow there is a chances of there is a repetition of the names, maybe their ID is different. So in not like in our class, we have something called Pawan is there, Pawan or Sandhya is there, or Srikant is there, or anything like that. Those people names are being repeated. So how I'll be identifying those people? By roll number. So roll number has been given to identify them as a unique person, and that number has been cannot be shared with some other. So like this, I am trying to make a relation in that particular table saying that this is a unique to identify the others. So this is how we are going to check it. So here the ID, employee ID is the primary key. Now when I'm saying primary key, the definition of the primary key says that this is compulsory and it should not be keep blank, or it says that it is uniquely identified. That means there is no repetition of this number. So once the 11 has been given to employee ID, the 11 is belongs to only Andrews Johnson. It is not belongs to any other person. So like that, I'll try to make this entire record. So here the record 11 Andrew Johnson is the unique record. Okay, there is no comparison between the Tom or the Alex. Okay, so Alex is again different to compare. If you compare the Tom Wood or the Alex Hale with some other person, then it's a unique. These are the other people which ID is 20. So this is the entire record says that this is unique to other. So how this will be identified? So if you say something like, what is the necessity of the key? Today's topic says that what is the necessity of the key? Okay, what are keys and what are different types of keys in the DBMS, and what are the other keys that are available in the DBMS, like super key, primary key, alternate key, candidate key, foreign key, compound key, composite key. Like this, we have different keys, and we'll going to know what is the difference between the primary and foreign key. So this is the topic. Today's topic we'll be knowing about this. So when I'm saying about the key, just now we have been identifying. So the first point is saying that it is to identify any row in a table. So if I want to identify any row in a table, okay, in the real world application, the table contains thousands of. So as I told you, there is a like data we are collecting, the raw data we are collecting, we are processing it, and we are trying to store the data in a long manner. So when it is storing that, so I should not find any duplicates. Okay, so the record should not be duplicated. To ensure those things, I'll be going to use the key, so not to have any kind of duplications in the records. So the first thing is that I have to identify the key so that there is an importance of that particular key. Then it allows the established relation between the identify the relation between the table. So one more chance of this key is that it will going to connect other tables. So if I want to connect one another table, then it is going to help me to establish the connection or the relation between the multiple tables. So if I want any table to be linked, that means one table should have the keys. Okay, then it will going to enforce identity and integrity of the relationship. So what is happening over here? So if the key is there, and if a relation is there, then there is no chance of duplicate. So data integrity will be there. That means I have been given multiple examples, like there is a master table and there is a child table. And in our case, I was telling about our college as an administration is the part one, then fee section or teachers attendance and the examination branch. These are the three departments depend on the admission. So if the number is existing in the admission, then only the student or the customers or the employees can go with the transaction. So as per our example, student is an example. So admission, if the person take the admission, he has to pay the fees. If the person pays the fees, he's been considered as admitted and he has to attend the classes and he has to write it. So these three are depend on that particular thing. So what is happening? If the admission person updates the details, then only the three is available. That means there is no manipulation in the other three departments. So that will go into make the identity and integrity. So this is what the integrity of the relationship. Okay. So we have different types of keys. So there are 7 types of keys are there. So in exam, most probably they will be asking about this, about the keys. In my exam, you can write 4 or 5. So they may not ask all the 7, but it's our duty to complete, as in our syllabus, 7 are there, so we have to go with the 7. So coming to the one by one, well, there is something called super key, primary key, candidate key, alternate key, foreign key, compound key, composite key, subdirect key. Like this, we have a lot of keys. So total 7 keys are there. So coming to the first key. So when I'm saying super key, so super key is a group of single or multiple keys which identifies rows in a table. Okay, that means it says that in my one single table, I have a lot of keys. So a column, that means I have been saying that name is in one column, it has some key. Then ID is having some key. Then contact is having some keys. Like that, if have multiple attributes in that particular row or a table, in that all the columns or multiple columns has some keys, some constraints. Say suppose like I want to allow the students whose age is more than 18. That means there is an attribute called age in my table. That one I'm putting a restriction that if the person is enter less than 18, he is not allowed to enter the record. So I'm putting some restrictions. So I have some key on that. So like that, I'm putting some restrictions. So till now, just I told about the employee ID. So I'm putting the restriction on the employee ID that it should not be duplicated. It should be unique. So I'm putting, now I'm putting the age as a restriction. Okay. Now I'm putting an Aadhaar card is compulsory. So like that, we have many columns or the records in a particular table. So I want to put each and every things as a key. So in that case, with that particular key is called as a primary key. Then coming to the second one, a primary key. So primary key is a column or a group of columns. Now here it is a records, multiple keys that is going to identify the rows. Now when I'm primary key, I'm saying it is for apply for a single column or a multiple columns, which is going to identify uniquely every row. So what is happening? In order to identify every row, I'm trying to put the columns. I have one first column or second column or third column. Like that, I'm trying to put the restriction on the columns. Okay. Now this is primary key. one by one we'll see the example, then we'll go to understand. Just we'll first of all we complete the definition of this, then we'll see the example so that you'll be getting understanding about this particular case. Then coming to the candidate key, again it is a set of attributes that uniquely identify tuples, that is rows in a table. Candidate key is a super key which is no repeated attributes. So what is happening comparing to the super key, here it is little bit different. How it is? It is having a set of attributes. Here we have set of rows, so it is identifying, super key is going to identify the rows. Now here the candidate key is going to identify the set of attributes, which is going to tell that it should not allow any repeated attributes. Say I have a date of birth, again I cannot take the date of birth. I have date of joining and I have a date of birth, though both are different. I should not have the another column called date of birth and again another column called date of birth. So I should not allow such kind of columns, that is attributes. So attributes and the columns are the one and the same, so don't get confused. So I should not have the same property for the entry. So such kind of things, if it is not having, then it is called as a candidate key. Then coming to the alternate key, is a column or a group of columns in a table, uniquely identify each row in that table. Okay, again, so what is happening here? It is again depending on the columns or the table for every row in that table. So it is similarly, if you see the primary key and alternate key, both are the same. See, here we have the column or a group of table that is uniquely identify the each row. So definition stays the same, but how it will be different, we will be seeing one by one. Then when I'm talking about the foreign key, it's very important among all the keys, it is depend on somebody. Okay, you have to remember that it is depend on somebody and it is going to create the relationship between the two tables. So if I want to have any relationship between the two or multiple tables, then that is primary key, foreign key. Now when I'm going for the foreign key, as I told that it is going to link the two tables, that means whichever the table it is linking, that table should have compulsory primary key. This is a point you have to remember. Okay, this is not in the material or something, but you have to remember that a foreign key is going to create the relation between the two tables or multiple tables. When it is linking the other table, the dependent table should have the primary key. That means to whichever the key table it is linking, that table should have the compulsory primary key. So here it says the maintain the data integrity. So with the help of this only data integrity is allowed. As I told you that admission has the number. So that number, if it gives to the examination branch or the fee section, then only they can. So here the data integrated will be maintained and there is a chances of avoiding duplicates. Okay. Now, then coming to the compound key. So coming to the compound key, it has two or more attributes that allow you to uniquely recognize specific record. It is possible that each column may not be unique, but itself within the database. So what is happening in the compound key? I have more than two attributes. In two attributes, I have two or unique key. How it will be, take something like Aadhaar number, contact number, and roll number. Now roll number is unique, Aadhaar number is unique, contact number is unique. So such kind of things, that means in one particular table, if we have more than such kind of attributes, then we call that attributes which is having their own importance, those we call as a compound key. Okay, then coming to the composite key, it's an artificial key which aims to uniquely identify each record. Okay, these records are uniquely because they are created when you don't have any natural primary key. Now I will be having something like in a table, I have a lot of keys. So the primary key is there, super key is there, candidate key is there. In such cases, something like I don't want that to be a primary key, but I want to maintain some key which is not have the symptoms of the primary key. So how it will be like? It's like a key which is going to say that if I don't have a primary, that means for my side, I will be giving the roll number to you. So say, in our case, everyone have roll numbers. So like something called 19143 or 121, 4315, 121, 4315, 2, like this we have unit number. So this is to identify your roll numbers, and this number will going to come all in your certificates and in your fees and everything. But when you going to take the transfer certificate, or when you going to take final memo, consolidated memo, there they'll going to give you some number. That number is admission number. That means at the time of taking the admission, they're going to maintain a unique key for it. That means maybe sometimes this can happen, so that your roll number has been given to someone, like you'll be having this number will be repeated, or this number sometime maybe miss, like all the sequence, like we have 20 students in our college, in our class. So I have given the number from 20, 143, 15, 01 to 20, 15, 20. Suppose in the second semester, the student has been got discontinued. Then after a couple of days or months or something like that, he wants to come and he wants to collect the transfer certificate. He forgot his contact or his number, his roll number. Then at that time, it is very difficult to pick up his report. So he will be asking at which year you have taken the admission. So they'll be saying 2019-20, I took the admission. So that makes the sense to pick up the record. Okay, then he'll go and search in the record 1920 BCom record. So they'll pick up the BCom record of 2019-20 batch record. Then they'll start searching. So there, the admission number has given the vital role comparing to the year primary. So this is how the composite key will go to work. Okay, then coming to the Sargret key. So here again, it is also an artificial key, same as the your composite key, but here you will be having again the same as the composite. Almost all both are the same. We'll see how this will work. So suppose here I have taken one example, coming to the one by one in depth with an example. So coming to the super key, as I told the definition, I have more than single key or a multiple key to identify. So here you can see, as I've given an example of employee SSN number and number. So this is employee number, employee name is there, and this is a separate identity of number. So social security number, SSN and social security number. As in our case, this is our admission number, this is your roll number, and this is your name. So what is happening? If I have multiple keys, so this is also one key, and it is also one key. So I'm saying this should not be repeated, and this should not be repeated. Okay, so another example I can say. I have the Aadhaar number and I have the roll number. Okay, so Aadhaar number will be the unique. So I should not have that number, should not be given. So it's a key. Okay, and your roll number. So roll number is not duplicated and the keys. That means you have multiple keys in a one single record. Okay, so in that case, this is called as a super. So it's very important for us. So I have multiple keys in a single record. Okay, next table. So this is different. So I can pick up the person by this or by this. So in that case, we call this as a super. Then coming to the primary key, as I told you, that it is going to apply for the column or a group of columns in order to identify the row, same as this one. But the thing is that it will not going to allow any duplicate. That is what the main important of this particular function. So it is not going to allow any duplicate keys. Same value cannot be appear more than once in a table. And it cannot, a table cannot have more than one primary key. So this is what you have to remember. A one particular table. So if this is a table, I cannot have more than one primary key. I can have the multiple keys for the columns. I can have the multiple keys for the column, but not for the table. So I can have only one table that should be primary. That means, what do you mean by this? If I say student table, and I can say fees table, these two are the different tables, and the table fee and the table student are uniquely identified. So we can have only one primary key in the particular table and one primary key in this particular table. So when I'm going for the primary key, we have certain rules. So some constraints are there. So you have to remember the constraint one by one. Two rows cannot have same primary key. Two rows cannot have the same primary key. That means I cannot have this primary key and I cannot have this as a primary key. Then it must every row have primary key values. So it must have every row. So this should be different and this should be different. What do you mean by that? Primary keys. This entire thing should not be same. Say here 98124 AB005 shown. Again 98124050598 and AB5 and shown should not be repeated. So it's a duplicate. So it should not have that kind of messages. So it is not going to allow it. Then second one, it must for every key have the primary key. That means this should be in this particular row. This is the primary key, or this is the primary key. So for every row, one should have the primary key. Okay, in this particular row, when I'm talking about this, AB06 is a primary key. So if you think that EMP number is a primary key, then this should not be duplicated. Then when I say it should not be not null, that means it should not be keep blank. That means roll number for this person or employee number for this person should be compulsory allotted. It should not be keep blank. That is what the input. So if I say the definition of the primary key in our normal words, we can say that it is not allowed the duplicates. It will not allow any blank, and it is mandatory. That means records should be entered compulsory. It should not be keep blank, and it is not going to allow any duplicates. So it is going to maintain the uniqueness. Now, when this particular row EMP number is having a primary key, then it is ready to link other table. That means if this is a table is having a primary key, then this EMP number can link with another table. So as I told you, that admission number and a fee section and the fee examination branch and the teacher's attendance can be linked. All these tables will be linked with another. How it is linked? If that particular table has one primary key. So here it says that the value of the primary key of a column can never be modified or be updated if any foreign key refers to that particular key. That means if this is linked to some other table, then I cannot modify AB005, because if it is modified, then the all link will be lost. So it before linking, you can change this things. You can add the new one, but you cannot modify this key. That means once this person, 21, 43, 15, 01, I have given this number to one person. And once the number has been allotted, that has been linked to fee section. So once the person record has been linked to the fee section, say the roll number 21, 43, 15, 01, then I cannot come to the admission and say that 1521 number 001 has to be removed and it should be some 025 or 36 like that. Then if you're modifying, that is not possible because it is already linked to some other table. Then what is the procedure? Wherever the table has been got linked, first you unlink them, then you modify, then you link. This is what the biggest process is. So that's why it says that whenever the key has been linked, it cannot be modified in the master table because it is been depend on. That means other tables are depend on this. So when the other tables are depend on this, that table we call child table, and this table we call as a master table. So this is the rules you have to keep in your mind. So here, if you see the example over here, so here I have something called student ID is there, roll number is there. So first name, last name, email is there. So roll number, which is been 1, 2, 11, 12, 13. Now this is the primary key. Or if I say here, if you say this is a bold one, say here I have bold one, and if you say roll number is there, first name is there, last name is there, among all these attributes, if you find this is a bold one, so if you think this is a bold, then this is a primary key. So this cannot be seen on the screen unless until we write it on the program. So here, just to in order to describe, I have been given as a bold one, but naturally it will not bold. Normally it will be said when we see the structure, it will go and tell about that. Whether it is key or not, it will go and tell you. Okay, so here this is the student ID is the primary key. Okay, then coming to the alternate key. So alternate key will say that is a column or a group of columns in a table that is uniquely identified every table. Okay, a table can have multiple choice for primary key, but only one can be set as primary key. So all the keys which are not primary key are called as alternate key. So this is the thing you have to understand. So what is happening? I can have this as a key, or I can have the key, or I can go with the name list. So I cannot, as I told you, for name and last name, I cannot go with the key. So I can go for a student ID as a key, or row number, can I have the key, or I can have the email also, I can have the key. Okay. But what it is saying, among all these, you have to decide which you want to put the primary key. And whenever you are decided that student ID should be the primary key, then rest of the things are the alternate keys. So rest of the things will be having alternate keys. So if you see in our case, so here in the student ID, roll number and qualified are can be a primary. So as I told you that this can be, this three can be a primary key, but student ID is a primary key. Roll number, email ID are the alternate keys. Okay. So this and this are the alternate keys. Okay. Then coming to the candidate key. So when I'm going with the candidate key, again, it is going to identify the tuples. So as I told you, what is tuples? So tuples are nothing but rows. So the candidate key is a super key which no repeated attribute. So it says that the thing is that when I'm telling about the candidate key, it's like a super key, but here we don't have any repeated keys. So that is, the attribute will not be repeated. So it is similar to the primary key. So primary key should select it from the candidate keys. So from this, so these are all are the keys in that you have to select the candidate key. Every table must have at least single candidate key. A table have multiple candidate key, but only single primary key. So you can have the lot of candidate keys, but I can have only one primary key for a table. So as I told you that table can have only one primary key. So here the rules for this. So how it will be? It must contain unique values. So when I'm saying candidate key, it should contains unique values. Say example, Aadhaar number. So here you remember it's an Aadhaar number. Candidate may have multiple attributes. So I have contact number, mail ID. Okay, so like this, we have multiple attributes, but must contain null values. So must not contain null values. So what is the definition of the null values? So as I told you, blank. So again, if you see, primary key also doesn't support the null values. So here, this is also not supporting null values. That means Aadhaar number should be empty. It should not be empty. Mail ID should not be empty. That means I am putting the restriction that you have to enter this value compulsory. It should contain minimum fields to ensure uniqueness. So I should have at least one or two fields so that it says that this is unique. Uniquely identify each record in a table. So if I say here, this is an example. Now if you remember this particular thing, so again the same example, student ID, roll number, name, last name, email. So student ID, roll number, and email are the candidate keys. So or we can say alternate keys also. But in this, it is going to help me uniquely identify the each record in a chip. So what is happening? This is comparing to this entire thing is different. This is different and this is different. See here, I have student ID, roll number, email ID, candidate key. Roll number and email, alternate key. See, candidate keys are, see, student ID is there, roll number is there, email ID is there. So these three are, can be anything. So we call this all our candidate key. Among this, one I have been fixed. So one I have fixed, this is a primary key. So one you are fixed, that means among the three. So roll number is there, ID is there, email ID is there. So these are all our candidate key. Among that, I am picking one primary key. So once the primary key has been picked up from the candidate key, then rest of the keys are called as an alternate. So this is what you have. So with a simple diagram, we can able to identify three different keys. So take one table, in that you identify the keys, that means that which we can say. So here in our case, student roll number and email, or I can say student roll number, Aadhaar number, contact number, something like that. So I can have like that the attributes. So these are all our attributes. So I have multiple attributes called as candidate keys. In that multiple attributes, we are removing the importance has been given because student ID I want, or I want to go with the next roll number. This is compulsory, I want to make it primary key. So I'm saying it's a primary key. So when I'm picking that primary key, then rest of the other two or three from the candidate key becomes the alternate keys. And what it is saying, the definition of the primary key or the candidate key or the alternate key says that it should not be duplicate, it should not be key blank, and it should be maintain uniqueness. This is the three things that the candidate key says, primary key says, alternate key says. So the definition of all the things are the same, but see how the it is related to each other. Then, as I told you that about the keys, the one among the important key is the foreign key, very important key. After the primary key, the priority will goes to the foreign key. Why? Because it is going to establish the link or establish the relation between the two tables, multiple tables. So, if I want to connect this table with another table, I need a foreign key concept. So, the foreign key concept will going to help me to link the tables. So, relation of the tables. Okay. So, how it is designed? So, what is the main purpose of this one? Because if I do like this, then I will maintaining the integrity. That means in all the tables, the data which it is flowing or the record that is flowing, I am maintaining the proper integrity. That means these are not repeated or in other tables also. Okay. So how it is possible? Say example, I have something called the table called department and the table called teacher. Okay. So I have something called department code and department. So we have 33 departments in our college. Okay, so science, English, computers, arts, okay, finance, management, like this, Sanskrit, English, Hindi, like this, we have multiple departments. So each and every department, I have a code. So I have been given some codes, right? Then I have a teacher ID. Now here in this particular table, department code is primary key. Department code is primary key. So remember this one. Then there is a teacher's database. Okay, the teacher profile is there. So teacher's profile, again, teacher name, he is having the name, okay, and he's having the last name. Then he is having his ID. Okay, I have his ID. Then how I'll be going to link these two tables? So profile of the teacher will should link with the department. That means this student, that means this particular David or Sarah or Mike, these are the people in working in different departments. So how I'll be linking this? In order to link this, first of all, I should say that this is a primary key and this is also a primary key. Okay. So in the two tables, they have their own primary key. Now I'll be linking. Now I will be linking this teacher with the department. So when I'm linking the teacher profile with the department, department become the master table and the teacher's department, this table will become the child table. Why? Because this is linking this. So in order to link this, I have to go with the concept called primary or foreign key. So how it will be linking? Now you can see here, I have been linking like this. So what is the final result over here? I got the ID of the teacher. I got the department code and I got the name and the last name. Now, two and one. See here, this department code is repeated. That means Sarah and David are from the same department. Mike is from the different department. Okay, but what is see, look over here, 2, 2, 1 is there. So here you can see 1 and 2 are there. Okay, I have 5, right? Apart from this, if I write here 3 and 6 or 7, then it should not going to allow me. Why? Because 6 and 7 are not in the department table. So here I have only 1, 2 and 5. Apart from this 1, 2, 5, if I try to give this teacher that you are belongs to some 007. Now 007, it doesn't exist. Okay. So when it is not existing, that means that it says that you first go to the department, cross verify whether the 7 is there or not. So it says that the foreign key will go into referential integrity. So here it is maintaining the integrity. Okay. It is maintaining integrity. It is not allowing the other than the numbers 1, 2 and 5. Okay, if 1, 2 and 5 is not is there in the department, then only the teacher has been allotted the department. If the other number has been allotted, then it says that you are not belong to our college or you have been or the ID is not matching with you. So please kindly refer to your master table. So this is how it is going. That means with the help of this. Now when I go with then say, suppose I want to know what is 002. Here if I check the 002, automatically it will go and link over here. And it is going to give me the information that 002 is nothing but English. So with the help of this particular key itself, I can get the information. That means whenever I want to know about the zero, so I'll have the hide the department names. So suppose I will asking so and so teacher David, what is his ID and what in which department he is working? So similarly, immediately you'll be saying his ID is 002 and his department is English. I'm not saying the code. With the help of the code, I'm trying to pull the data from this particular table. So automatically the two means automatically it will go into C, give me the answer that David is from English department. Okay, Mike is from computer department or science department. So it will going to give me the answer. So it has been linked from one table to another in this fashion. Okay. So you have to remember when I'm going with the foreign key, it's very important that whatever the keys that are available in the master table, those keys only I can use, and I don't have any restriction that I cannot have more than one sort of. So here I cannot put this department code as a unique key, because these are the unique keys, but not maybe duplicated. Why? Because it's not a primary key, it's a foreign key. Why it is a foreign key? Foreign key because this two and one are been coming from here. I'm not typing. Whenever I'm getting this one, it has been taken from database from this particular, because it is linked over here. So if I'm trying to enter other than this one, two and five, then it will go on to say that this key is not existing in your master table. Okay. So you can see the definition. So we have two tables. So however, there is no way to see the search key in the departments in the table, adding the foreign key, department code and the name, we will create a relationship. So how will we going to create this? We will be going to learn in the third unit, because once we know about the topic, then only we can go with the practical syntax. Okay. Then coming to the compound key. So when I'm talking about the compound key, I have multiple keys. So multiple attributes will be having to specific record, and it cannot be have the same uniqueness itself in the database. So when I'm talking about this, if I say this, here I have something called order number is there, product ID is there, product name is there, quantity is there. So here in our example, order number and product number are two different. So in our case, it cannot be a primary key. Okay, it cannot be a primary key, as does not uniquely identify in the record. So this cannot be a primary key, this cannot be a primary key. See here, 005, 005 is there. And the product ID is different. This is the product ID. So I can have the orders like this. So here you should think that when I'm taking about the compound key, so I have the numbers. So two columns are there where they are different, but they are not primary keys. So definition of the primary key, we know that it should not have the duplicate. See here, 005 is there, 005 is there, 005 is there. Okay. Five is the number, order number is there, but their product is different. So their product is different. See how the product is different. Here the 5 is there, for this it is a mouse. Here 5 is there, for this it is a USB. For this is 5 is there, there is an LCD monitor. But if you see how it has been separated by the product code. So with the help of the product code, I am trying to say that it's an, though we have the order number same, but I have the different product. So like this, in our case, we can identify. If we have such kind of attributes in this fashion, okay, which allow only uniqueness. So we have this one, we have this one. So I have this column and this column, but it is saying unique. So here product ID is different. So you have to remember this one, product ID is different compared to order number. So though we have two numbers, which has been attributes, two attributes are there, among that one attribute, which is having uniqueness. Okay, not primary key. Okay, so primary key is not allow duplicates. Okay, and it will not going to allow any blank. So it is maintaining uniqueness. So here the same thing, it should maintain uniqueness. So though the product and order number is and product numbers are uniquely identified columns, but when I'm going with this comparing, I am saying that this is product ID is different. So that is what the definition of the compound key. Then remaining two are there. So the another one is composite key. So when I'm saying composite key, it's a combination of two or more columns uniquely identifying the row. So the combination of the row columns guarantees uniqueness. Then through individual uniqueness, though individual uniqueness is not guaranteed. Hence, this may be combined as a uniquely identified records in a chip. So what is happening here? If you find the difference between the compound key and this one, here in the difference between the compound and the compound key is the part of the compound key can be a foreign key, but the composite key may be or may not be part of the foreign key. So if you see here, If you see this above example, what is happening in this? This is also there and this is also there. So this is what is happening. It is maintaining uniqueness. And this is what happening. These numbers are coming from some other table. Okay, this is not see, it is having duplicates here. See, B005 is there. That means it can be one person or who has taken the different items whose product is this one. So this may be a customer number, it can be anything. So this is the order has been given by so and so person. Now this 542 are reflecting from some other table. So these numbers can be stored from some, that means this table is linked. So this order number is linked to some other table called orders. Like I have been telling about these two tables. If you remember these two tables, so here 1, 2, 5 has been linked to student the teacher's profile. So 2, 2 has been see here. This is repeat. That means what I'm saying, this department code is a primary foreign key to the another table. So similar fashion, what the composite key will say is that if you have such kind of things, in this one can have the foreign key. So here it says that one can be a foreign key. So difference between the compound and the composite is that compound key can be a foreign key. So here this is a compound key. So this is a compound key. This is a foreign key. But composite may be or may not be part of the foreign key. That means this can be or this can be maybe a part of the other table. Okay. That means it can be a foreign key or may not be foreign key. So this is what the definition of the composite key. Then coming to the surrogate key, as I told you that this is an artificial key. It is identify the record like this. So how it will be happen? So here if you see that, I have something like this. Okay. Now if you see here, this name and there is there, but if you say start time and end time automatically generated. Okay, and what is happening, you won't find any duplicates over it because I cannot have 99 or and that means a person cannot join at the same time or can leave at the same time. There is a slight difference, even 1 or 2 seconds also, 1 or 2 minutes also, there is a difference. So that means it says that it's like a partial key of the DBMS maintaining uniqueness. See here, it is all are unique. So these are all are unique. Okay, like we have been having the, like we have been joining the this Zoom. Some people will be, because of the network, they'll come join again and again and they leave. Okay, so how many times they leave? That means this person, so first name or the last name, that means Sai. Sai is the person who has been coming, logging in the Zoom many times and leaving many times because of network problem. So how many times he leave it, or how many times he started, how many times he wind up, all the details will be coming and it will be maintain uniqueness. So this is what the surrogate key. So what is it says that it is going to create it when you don't have any natural primary key. That means I don't have any key for this. See, I don't have any key for this person. Okay. At that time, I'll be depending something which is going to generate automatically. So it is going to say that value generated before the record is inserted into the table. That means it is automatically generated. That means Annie and Smith, when I'm trying to enter it, immediately it is going to give me that this person has entered at this time and he left the time. So this is what the example of surrogate key. So here, what is the key will be saying that in SQL, how I'll be finding, no property has a primary parameter of the primary key. So if you see this, it doesn't have any properties. That means I cannot have any attribute like this. So attribute can be anything. So there is no format is to be followed for this particular key, that this should be given like this. So there is no particular parameters. And in the table, when a primary key is too big or complicated. Okay. So when I'm going to define this one, this particular thing, that means if I have a lot of columns in a table and it is very big or complicated, then at that time I'll be try to use this particular keys in order to differentiate the record. Okay. Then another important one you'll find in that they'll be always asking about the difference between the foreign key and the primary key. So if you say that it is going to identify the unique. So you're going to have the uniqueness and it will not accept any null value. That means it will not allow any empty values. Okay. And it has only single table. So primary key will have the single table. And it will be having index, cluster index we'll say. Index is like in order to pick up the data faster and faster. So you will be having a book. So if I want to read a book, I will be not reading the entire book. I want to go with an index column. So you'll be having a content column and index column where it is going to tell that I want to read this particular topic. So instead of reading the entire book, directly you jump, you make you to jump to that particular topic and read it. That means where is the DBMS? What are the advantages? So I want to read today's topic, is advantage and disadvantage, or I want to know about the primary. So I'll go to this index, then I'll find where is this primary key is there. Okay, it is on the page 17. Then I'll jump to the 17 and I'll go on read that particular page. So this is how it will go. That means when I go for the primary key, automatically it is going to create an index form. That means it is going to maintain the index form. So the index is going to help you to pick up the records faster and faster. Okay, so this is about the primary. Now comparing to this foreign key, what is the difference over here? So it is a deep field in a table that is primary key of the another. That means it is a table which is linked from the other table. It will going to allow multiple null values. So it will not going to restrict. Here it is accepting the null values, but it will not going to here. It is not allow the null values. So in the primary key, it will not accept the null values. Here it is going to accept the null values. Then here I say index. Here I don't have any index constant because automatically create an index. It will not going to create any automatically, or it will not going to cluster anything. Manually you have to create the index if we have a primary foreign key. That means if the table is reflecting to another table, we have to create the index. But here in the primary key, that is not the case. Automatically it will go. Here it will be having one primary key, but here I can have the multiple foreign keys. That means I can one table can link n number of tables with different foreign keys. Okay. So this is the today's topic. So if you have any doubts, you can just clarify. Just I'll share this videos by today evening and go through this all this. Then if you have any doubts, you can just clarify. Okay. Yeah, any more doubts now? If you don't have doubts, then I'll stop the class here only.